Hi, my name is Jordan Webster, and I am a math faculty here at MidMichigan Community College. I'm going to do a short guide through the general education program for transfer students at MidMichigan Community College. So as I've alluded to, the newly revised general education program is going to apply to you if you are a transfer student and you want to obtain a transfer degree. Now, there's many types of transfer degrees, but the general education, the new general education program applies to the business studies, the criminal justice, the health science, the liberal studies, the math, the science, and the visual arts transfer degrees. So to most students, the biggest part of the general education program comes down to which classes you have to take to complete this general education portion of your transfer degree. So I'm going to do a quick rundown of which classes you'll have to take in the general education program. If you want to complete the transfer degree here, you'll have to take two English courses, one communication course, one quantitative reasoning course, two science courses, two humanities and fine arts courses, and two social science courses. Now, I've talked about courses, but I do want to emphasize at this stage that the general education program is not just a collection of courses, but there's going to be some interwoven themes throughout general education courses, and especially those courses in what's called the gen ed intensive categories, which I'll get into in a bit. You saw the number of courses listed for each category in the previous slide. However, there are restrictions on what counts as a general education course in each category. First of all, to count for general education, you do have to pass it. You have to pass it with a C, in fact. If you take a course and fail, then it's not counted as fulfilling the requirement. Secondly, not all math courses count towards the general education program's quantitative reasoning requirement, and similarly, not all English courses are counted towards the English requirement. So there are restrictions on which courses count for general education in each category. And each category works a bit differently. I'm going to go through those one by one in the next slides. The first category that we're going to go through is the English category. Now, in English, you have to have two courses. And moreover, those courses have to be English 111 and English 222. So you need to take both of these classes and pass both to fulfill the English requirement of the general education portion of your transfer degree. In communication, you have basically two options. You can either take Speech 101 or you can take Speech 257. If you recall, there was one communication course that you had to take. So you can pick from either of these two courses. You're required to take one course in the quantitative reasoning category. Now that course can either be Math 114, which is mathematical reasoning, Math 107, which is college algebra, or Math 212, which is probability and statistics. Any course below these would not count towards the general education portion of your transfer degree. For instance, Math 104 or Math 105 would not count, at least not in the sense counting for the general education program. In science, if you recall, there were two required courses. Now, these two required courses, if you want to complete the general education program, one of the courses must be in what's called the Gen Ed Intensive List. This is a list of courses that determined by the faculty to illustrate some of the concepts and ideas of the general education program. You can see here that we've listed out the Gen Ed Intensive Lists. So Biology 100 and 101, Chemistry 105 and 111, Physics 105 and 211, and Science 200. So if you're looking to complete the general education program, you'll have to take one of those courses, and then also you'll have to take one course from what's called the Michigan Transfer Agreement List, or MTA List. This list is determined by the college, and it includes everything on the Gen Ed Intensive List, plus quite a few other courses in the science area, in the natural science area. So you'll have to take one course from the Gen Ed Intensive List and one course from the Natural Sciences MTA List. Now, I'll also say here, for science in particular, one of the two courses you have to choose must contain a lab component. And also, if you do choose a course with designator bio from the Gen Ed Intensive List, the other course that you count for general education purposes must have a different designator. So that may be either a bio and a chem, or a bio and a physics, or a bio and a science. Or there are many other natural science designators that you can see in the MTA list. The humanities and fine arts category works a lot like the science category. Although there's no lab component, you're going to have to choose two courses. One from a Gen Ed Intensive List in the humanities and fine arts area, and one course from the MTA list in the humanities and fine arts area. Now, again, you see we've listed here the Gen Ed Intensive List in the humanities and fine arts area. You see English 213, Humanities 200, Humanities 251, 252, Philosophy 210. The MTA list in the humanities and fine arts area can be found on MidMichigan Community College's website. Now, just like in the natural sciences category, in the humanities and fine arts category, the two classes that you choose must have different designators. So if you choose a Humanities 200 as one of your classes, the other class must have a different designator. However, there's clearly no lab component as there was in the natural sciences area. The last category is the social science category, and it works almost identically to the humanities and fine arts category. Two courses you have to take. One of them must be from the Gen Ed Intensive List in the social science area. The other must be from the MTA list in the social science area. You can see here a listing of the general education intensive courses for the social science area. That is History 223, Psych 205, and 212, Sociology 200, 202, and Social Sciences 200. Again, just like in the humanities category, the two courses that you choose, one from the MTA list and one from the Gen Ed Intensive list, must have different designators. Now, you may have heard about something called the Michigan Transfer Agreement, and you may not have, but our general education program is set up to align with the Michigan Transfer Agreement. For those of you who don't know, the Michigan Transfer Agreement is a 30-hour credit block which is basically a block transfer to any institution which is signed on to the Michigan Transfer Agreement in the state of Michigan. The goal of the Michigan Transfer Agreement was to make it easier for students to transfer between institutions. So what we've done is we've made it so that if you complete our general education program, then you will have satisfied the requirements of the MTA. So then you will have a 30-hour credit block that will transfer to any Michigan institution which is signed on. I will say that general education program is not the only way to satisfy this 30-hour credit block. And if you have questions about that, you can look up more on the MTA on Mid-Michigan Community College's website, or you can talk with your advisor. And with that, I do want to say that if you have questions on your transfer degree or how the Michigan Transfer Agreement works, or on the general education program here at Mid-Michigan Community Colleges, then talk with your advisor. And also talk to your advisor about how best to choose the courses in the Gen Ed Intensive list and the MTA list within the categories. Certain courses may align better with the program you want to get into at your future institution. We hope this video helped make the general education program understandable, and we wish you luck in your educational career at Mid-Michigan Community College and beyond.